Welcome to Krishna's online lectures. In this video, I am going to discuss about the location of center of gravity. In previous lesson, I have discussed about the location of centroid. Now, how we can locate the center of gravity in a particular body which is having mass and weight, I am going to discuss here. Let's start the lesson. As we know, the difference between centroid and center of gravity. So, if we define centroid, so centroid we consider as the center point of a plane which has area, volume, dimension, but it does not have mass. There will be no mass for the plane, and the plane consists the center point that is called the centroid. Now, if we talk about the center of gravity, so center of gravity, we consider the center point of any object or any body which has mass as well as area, volume, dimension, everything with mass. So, in centroid, we don't consider mass, but center of gravity, the body which is having area, volume, dimension and mass. So, location of centroid and location of center of gravity is completely different, because centroid we generally define for two-dimensional object, mostly two-dimensional object, and the center of gravity we generally define for three-dimensional object. Now, how we can define center of gravity? So, here we will prefer the same diagram which we have seen in the location of centroid. So, here we are taking or we are considering one body. This is the arbitrary shape body. This is our body, and this body will have everything: dimension, area, volume, mass, as well as we can also consider weight. So, weight, this weight we can define on the basis of mass. Weight is equals to mg. So, we can define on the basis of mass into this gravitational acceleration. This is representing weight. So, this body having everything. Now, here if we are considering the total mass of the body is m, and if we are defining the position of center of gravity by g, let us consider the centroid or the center point of this three-dimensional body or three-dimensional object which is having area and mass and volume, everything. So, g is the center point. So, this center point will be the center of gravity. Now, here if we are considering this particular body is placed in a plane. So, here this x plane and y plane we are considering as the reference plane. So, on the basis of this x axis and y axis position, we can define the location of center of gravity of this particular body, and we will define the position similar to centroid only. Here we will consider particular distance of this g from y axis as well as particular distance of this g from x axis. So, let us consider the distance x bar is the distance of g from y axis, and this distance y bar is the distance of g or the center of gravity from x axis. So, on that basis, we can define the coordinates of this g as x bar and y bar. So, let us consider the coordinates of g as x bar and y bar. Now, if we are defining the value of x bar and y bar, so on the basis of these coordinates, we can define or we can locate the exact position of center of gravity. So, the concept is same, but the difference is this particular body is having, with area, volume and dimension, it will have mass also. So, centroid we have defined on the basis of moment of area. Here, if we define the moment of force, so moment of force we generally define by this formula F into perpendicular distance D, or we can take L also. But if we define the moment of area, so in place of force, we will keep here the value of area. So let us consider area of this body as A. So, here if we want to define the moment of area, so moment of area we will define as the area multiplied by the perpendicular distance from any axis. So, here moment of area we generally define with respect to y axis and with respect to x axis. मोमेंट ऑफ फोर्स वी जनरली डिफाइन एज फोर्स इनटू परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस एंड दिस परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस वी जनरली डिफाइन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ वन रेफरेंस पॉइंट. नाउ हियर वी हैव टू डिफाइन द पोजीशन ऑफ सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी. सो सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी पोजीशन वी विल डिफाइन बाय द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मोमेंट ऑफ मास. नाउ हाउ वी कैन डिफाइन द मोमेंट ऑफ मास. सो इफ वी वांट टू डिफाइन द मोमेंट ऑफ मास, सो इन प्लेस ऑफ एरिया वी विल पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ मास. So, moment of mass will be mass into perpendicular distance. At this perpendicular distance, we will consider from any axis. So, here, if we want to define the location of G, so we have to define the position of X bar and the value of Y bar. X bar and Y bar we have to define. So, this particular X bar is represented as the perpendicular distance of point G from Y axis. Now, if we want to define the perpendicular distance from x-axis, so it will be y bar. Now, how we can define? So here, we are dividing this body into number of parts. So let us consider these straight lines are representing the different parts of this body, which is having total mass m. And if we define the number of masses for these number of parts, so let us consider for part 1 the mass is m1, for part 2 the mass is m2, for part 3 the mass is m3, let us consider the part 4, so mass will be m4, and if we are considering nth part, so mass will be mn. So if we define the total mass of the body, so the total mass will be summation of m, summation of all, summation of m, it will be m1 plus m2 plus m3 up to mn. So here this particular summation of m is defining the total mass. In centroid we have defined area, so area will be a1 plus a2 plus a3 up to an. This is representing summation of area. Now here we have to define the moment of mass, so we have to define summation of mass, so it will be m1 plus m2 plus m3 plus mn. And here we will define the separate center point for each mass or for each part. So let us consider G1, G2, G3 up to Gn as the center of gravity for each mass or for each part of the body. Now here, if we are considering the reference axis as y-axis, so we have to define the position of the center point from the y-axis. So let us consider X1 as the distance of this first G1 or this center of gravity G1 of mass M1 from Y axis. Similarly, for G2, the distance will be X2. For G3, the distance will be X3. So, from Y axis, these are the distances. Now, from X axis, we will define the distances. So, according to position of G1, G2, G3 and Gn, we will define the distance of these Gs from x-axis. So let us consider the perpendicular distance of this particular centroid or center of gravity of this particular body. So for first point, let us consider distance y1. For second point, let us consider distance y2 here from x-axis. And for nth point, we can consider distance as yn, and these distances is defining the exact position of G1, G2, G3 up to Gn from x-axis, and this X1, X2, X3 are defining the position of G2, G1, G2, G3 up to Gn from the y-axis. Now here we will apply the same concept, only we will replace the area with mass. So here we have summation of mass. Now if we want to define the moment of mass about y-axis, so about y-axis it will be, it can be, if we want to define the moment of mass, so this is our formula of moment of mass for this particular body about y-axis. If we define separate moment of mass, so for this first part it will be m1x1. Here m1 is the mass of the first part, and from y-axis perpendicular distance we have, it is x1. For second part it will be m2 x2. For third part, it will be m3 x3. For nth part, it will be mn xn. So here we have separate moment of mass. Mass into perpendicular distance from y-axis. Now if we want to define the total moment of mass, so total moment of mass for this particular body, we will define as the summation of moment of mass of each part or of each mass m1, m2, m3. So let us consider the mass as dm. So accordingly, we will define the value of moment of mass for the total mass and for the separate mass. So if we define, or if we are considering this particular concept, so accordingly, we can define the total moment of mass as m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus m3 x3. So it is defined as summation of mx, and it will be defined as mx bar. So here we are considering total area. So let's consider this mass as capital M. So you can understand the difference between these separate masses and the total mass. So let us consider this total mass as capital M. So this particular term will be capital M x bar, that is equals to summation of mx, and it will be equals to m1 x1 plus m2 x2 up to mn xn. So this summation of mass we are defining as capital M. So here in place of this capital M, we can put summation of m. So if we want to define the value of x bar with the help of this concept, so x bar is representing the position of center of gravity from y axis. So this formula will be summation of mx by summation of m. In centroid, we have defined x bar as summation of ax by summation of a. So simply we are replacing this area with mass here. Now here, this is the position of x bar. Now if we want to define the position or the value of y bar from x axis, this we are considering from x axis, and this particular x bar we are considering from y axis. So if we want to define from y, this particular x axis, we already defined x bar from y axis. So we want to define the value of y bar from x axis. So we will apply the same concept. So here we will define the moment of mass for each and every, for each part. So it will be m1, y1, m2, y2. So we will apply the same concept here. And we will define the value of y bar as summation of my by summation of m. So we will simply replace this x with y. So the summation of my will be m1, y1. Here the summation of my will be m1, y1 plus m2, y2 up to some mn, yn. So here we will put this particular value to define the value of y bar. Now we have these two equation or these two formulas. So with the help of value of x bar and y bar, we can define the position in terms of g x bar y bar. We have to define the coordinates of g from y axis and from x axis. So the concept is completely same, but in place of area, we have to put, or we have to here replace this area with mass. So the center of gravity is based on the mass of the object, and centroid is based on the area of the object. So here we will consider moment of mass, and in centroid we will consider moment of area. Now here we have a body which has area, volume and weight and mass. Now let us consider the material of the body or material of the object. Let us consider the material is homogeneous material for complete body, or let us consider these number of areas are made of same material. So in that case, the density of material will be same. So if we want to define the mass, so mass we can define on the basis of density into volume. So it will be for m1, we can define as rho v. Mass basically we define as rho into v. This is the formula of mass. So where rho is the density and v is the volume. Here, this rho is the density and V is the volume. So, this M1 will be rho V1, M2 will be rho V2, Mn will be rho Vn, where V1, V2, V3 up to Vn are representing volume of each part or each section of the this particular body. Here we will consider V1 for second part, V2 for third part, V3, and for nth part it will be Vn. So if we want to define the total volume of the body, so it will be V1 plus V2 plus V3 up to Vn according to number of parts. Now if we want to define the value of X bar and Y bar in terms of density and volume, so X bar in place of M, we can put rho into V. So it will be summation of rho V into X divided by summation of rho V, where rho V is representing mass. So this will be our equation. Now here we have same density. So this density and this density will cancel out. So our equation will be V into X. Now if we put the formula of volume, so volume we generally consider as area into dimension, length. So it will be, in place of V, we will put A into L. So it will be ALX and this V will be A into L. Now we know the area of this particular object is same. If we combine the number of area, so the summation of number of area will be the total area. So the summation of A will be cancel out. So it will be summation of LX by L. So on the basis of length also, we can define the position now of X bar. Similarly for Y bar, we will put same equation, rho V Y by rho V. So the final term we will get for Y bar, it will be L Y by summation of L Y by summation of L. So here we can define another formula of X bar and Y bar, or basically the position of G on the basis of X bar and Y bar in terms of length or in terms of this area also. So here this is another formula to define X bar and Y bar. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can rate, review and share this lesson with your friends and your known people. And if you want to watch more lessons related to mechanical engineering, please subscribe the channel.